Good afternoon, all. I, Mrs. Kalyani Morone, and my colleague, Mrs. Mamta Kore, focusing how project-based learning is enjoyable forever with computational thinking. Project-based learning gives students the opportunity to explore problems and challenges that have real-world applications, increasing the possibility of long-term retention of skills and concepts. Computational thinking skills is one of the 21st century skills, and Mega Group of Schools has taken initiative and integrated CT in our curriculum from 2018. Due to an increase in population, infrastructure, and public attitude, among others, waste management is considered as a crucial issue. Every person is a generator of waste and thus a contributor to this problem. To generate waste is one thing, the type of waste generated is another, and the way the generated waste is managed or disposed of is quite a different issue. So taking into consideration these issues, 4 months project from July to October was given to Standard 8 students. Students were given step-by-step task sheet having computational skills. Let us see how our students are developing problem-solving skills through computational thinking. Initially, task sheet is given and explained to the students. According to the guidelines, students have to study the different wastage at their home. Students collected the data through observation and interaction with their parents. They listed out the different waste at home, for example, water, electricity, paper, plastic, etc. And they shared their list of wastage in a class. From the list of wastage, students started processing, segregating waste as non-biodegradable, biodegradable, liquid waste, etc. While processing information, they applied CT skill, that is information processing, which they learned in Standard 5th CS Pathshala Module 5IP02. For collecting data from a relative or from neighbor, students of near about 40 in a class created different Google forms. And it was difficult to manage data correctly if we were using different forms. To avoid this, students, with the help of teacher, created same questionnaire and then started collection of data. While making Google form, students used their ICT skills.
These are the responses students collected from Google form. Data analysis refers to dividing a whole into its separate components for individual examination and converting it into information useful for decision making. With the help of responses, students did the data analysis, made a graph, and found about which type of wastage is the issue. Students used their ICT skills to build the graph using Excel. An algorithm is a sequence of steps. An algorithm helps to achieve a big task by breaking it into smaller set of tasks. Algorithms are very useful for solving different kinds of problems. Students used these concepts of algorithm learned in CT and wrote algorithm to reduce plastic, managing garbage, making compost, save electricity. Here, students use CT skill algorithm which they have learnt in 06DA01. The students who participated in the life skill project showed a positive impact on the development of classroom activities as well as motivation to learn. Data collection of this project was helpful in inculcating life skill of do not waste. waste of out of waste, as well as for developing environmental sensitivity. Abstraction is one of the components of computational thinking that help us make one solution work for similar problems. Generation of waste at home is a common problem, and students come up with the generic solution to reduce waste. Is reusing the non-biodegradable waste like plastic. Here, students try to inculcate social awareness of reusing plastic in an innovative way. Let us now see one video of Best Out of Waste.
My name is Sharvari Nitin Ingole and my class is 8C. My roll number is 13 and today I am making a stool. Today we are making this kind of a stool. For that, we need any two colored clothes, a color bucket, it's a big one, any decorative lace, fevicol and a large sponge. First, we will make base of this. For that, we need to remove the handle and take the lid away. For base, I am using black colored cloth and I will wrap it. Then I will cut the sponge as per size of it and then I will wrap this cloth to it. I have wrapped the black colored cloth and decorative lace to the bottom of the stool. I have placed the foam as per the size of the upper part of the lid. Now our stool is ready. We can sit on it and we can keep anything in it. Thank you. My name is Sharvari Nitin Ingole and my class.
With this, we conclude that while processing information, they applied CT skill, that is information processing, from CS Pathshala module 05 IP02. For writing an algorithm of reducing waste, students used CT skill algorithm for module 06 DA01. Applied patterns data analysis part for making sense of data by organizing it, finding patterns and depicting it in graphs. Applied CT skill abstraction and given solution for reducing plastic by reusing it. Computational thinking allows students to be active rather than passive. Computational thinking encourages children to scrutinize a problem and build a solution for it. This is a general problem solving that can be integrated with other fields like mathematics, science, etc.
Thank you.
Hello everyone. This is Manisha Girolkar from Dr. Kalmadi Shamrao High School, Ganeshnagar, Pune. I am very happy and excited to share my experiences with all of you through this virtual platform. Our school was one of the pilot schools in Pune to start computational thinking curriculum by CS Pathshala in 2016. Along with teaching computers as a subject, I am engaged with my students working on various innovative projects under ATR. Presently, six computer teachers and two ATL facilitators are involved in CT activities. So here, integrating computational thinking into the present high school syllabus has always been a challenging task for the teachers. Even the computer science syllabus hardly had the element of CT, and going from CT activities to syllabus integration is a long road. So today's my topic is how we have achieved the goal of implementation of computational thinking to all of grade levels in our school. So here the background about my school. Kaveri Group of Institutions, Dr. Kalmadi Shamrao High School, Ganeshnagar branch has 1500 students from standard 5 to 10 We have got CBSE affiliation in 2018, and we have also set up Atal Tinkering Lab under Atal Innovation Mission. Presently, the classes are conducted online, but we have included computer and ATL periods in the timetable. So here in my presentation, I would like to present a review of our CT integration for all grade levels over the past 5 years. The challenges we faced and the variation we have done and how those variations impacted the students' learning, especially in this online schooling. So while implementing CT, we received constant support from CS Pathshala at every phase. The various teachers' training programs helped us to understand the concept of CT. What is the difference between ICT and CT? How it is helpful for real-world problem solving, etc. For Standard 5 and 6, we could easily add CT activities which were readily available on CS Pathshala website. We introduced Scratch programming to Standard 6, and looking at the students' interest and engagement, we extended Scratch programming for Standard 7 as well. But here we focus on game development. After some guided project, we give them liberty to create their own games, and they come forward with amazing ideas. And overall impact can be seen in the quality of work of our students presenting in different platforms. In 2016, they hardly could understand Webra challenge, but now they wait for annual Webra challenge. And to increase awareness about Webras, we have given weightage of 10 marks to Webra score in our annual computer evaluation. So now our 100% students appear for Webras. And I am proud to share with you that this year we have national topper from our school. Now coming to the higher secondary, where we don't have much scope to change the syllabus. And for 9th and 10th, we have to follow the board's pattern. But by changing pedagogy, we can achieve our goals of integrating CT. Like in Standard 8, we were taking HTML from the beginning. But now we focus on their algorithmic thinking and decomposition strategies. Instead of introducing HTML tags directly, we ask students to explore different websites, find out main components, draw relationship maps of the connected content. Now the main challenge was for Standard 9. If you look at the syllabus, it includes non-programming content like internet, cyber safety, and all ICT tools like word processor, spreadsheets, PowerPoint presentation, video editor, photo editor, etc. So the most important point that the school like ours, where we are consciously focusing on enhancing students' learning ability. And after coming in Standard 9, our learning objective cannot be simply achieving digital literacy. Especially due to this online schooling, every child has become so smart in handling the tools. You must have experienced when you stuck somewhere during the online class, within no time you start getting smart suggestions to solve the glitch from your students. So it becomes very necessary to find out more interesting and engaging way to teach, rather I can say, explore the ICT tools. And yes, there is a need of variation. But whatever variation we want to do, it should be compatible to online learning environment. So here we decided project-based learning. But for that, I need to tell you a background. As you know, we have established ATL in our school in 2017. Our students have been working on various innovative projects with a strong foundation of computational thinking, clarity of design thinking process, and problem-solving skills. Some of the students always come forward to solve real problems. Recently, we launched mobile library program, and I really feel proud to share with you that The whole program was run by our students. It started with the problem that the school library books and the school vans both have been unutilized for more than a year due to this unprecedented situation of COVID-19. To solve the problem, a team of 15 students from standard 9 and 10 came forward. They first chose a class, a sample class, that was standard 7 for pilot program. They conducted online survey to get the clear idea from parents, their preferable timings and location to pick up the books. They analyzed the data and put forward the plan. Before starting the work on web portal, they presented pseudocode. They asked about required databases, the flow of the system. They explained to us from the students and librarian points of view. One group of students taken the task of designing poster and creating tutorial video, and another group was for coding, and they concentrated on development of web portal. When the system got ready, they tested and debugged. And at last, we launched a pilot program, which was a great success. There are some other projects on which students are working. And you can see in the process, they have used all ICT tools more than prescribed by the board. And of course, they demonstrated their CT skills as well at different stages of project development. So it is not a great way to teach them Word, Excel, PowerPoint by giving some hypothetical assignments. Let's adopt project-based learning, we decided. Now, there were two major obstacles. One was how to implement this in online mode, and another, if we involve 240 students, how to handle those many projects. So out of different types of projects like design or makers project, coding project, community service projects, we selected research project, survey-based research or investigation project, so that students can carry out the project online without stepping out of their houses. And to allot the projects, we took help of our ATL team. And students are expected to complete the task. First, choose the problem area, then abstract and articulate a problem statement, creating Google survey, collecting data, analyzing it using spreadsheet, present the project in the form of PPT or video, then making posters and flyers, then submitting the project report using Google Doc or Word, or they can use online book creator or Canva. So you can see in the process, along with using ICT tools, they use CT skills as well, like abstraction, algorithmic thinking while planning the project, decomposition, data analysis, pattern recognition. They can generalize the results for larger population after conducting the research on sample set. So in this way, we could successfully implement computational thinking for all. Students got opportunity to explore, inquire, and create. In the breakout room discussions, they got chance for debating and critical thinking. With cloud-based application, sharing documents among groups, they experience collaborative learning as well. And most importantly, they could connect classroom knowledge to the real world. Here are some examples, like how was the online schooling experience of KHS students, survey on mental health, then survey on Chinese goods, and research about the drainage system of our locality. So here I can say that we are towards achieving the goal of participation of our 100% students in city activities over the last 5 years. And this we could achieve with the support of CS Pathshala. So I am really thankful to them. And here, special thanks to Sonia ma'am for guiding me for this presentation. Thanks to SOS for organizing this event. successfully. Thank you. Thank you all.